After coding, the next step is to categorize your code to develop themes. So how do you do that when you are using NVivo? That's what I'm going to show you. So the first step that you have to think about is to decide whether you're going to categorize your codes in NVivo or you want to categorize them outside and then bring it back to NVivo. So as you can see here, you can categorize them. So looking at the relationship, you can bring, let's say if this one is related to this, you can just drag and drop, right? But it's easy if you have all the codes outside and do the categorization, because here you may have to decide what kind of theme do you have to generate so that you can drag and drop all these codes under them. And then this space is not conducive for you to do that analysis. So I always recommend that you export all the codes into Excel and then use Word document to do the categorization. I'm going to show you how to do it. But before I show you, just a recap based on my initial presentation on NVivo. One thing that you have to think about is that sorting is all about grouping codes based on their relationship. You examine each of the codes and find out, can I combine them? So you are looking at the commonalities between the codes and then see whether you can group them into categories. We're going to export all the codes from NVivo to Excel spreadsheet, as you can see here. And we're going to create a table and categorize the code into various clusters. After that, we do that for each of the research questions, right? And we label the clusters based on the content that you have here. So that's what we are going to do. So let me show you how to export your code. So in exporting the code, this is what you're going to do. You can just easily right click any place here, go to exports and click on export list. Then you can look for a place to save that information. You can give it any name, code for project 2. Then you look for a place. So I want to save it here and click on OK. So then what you have to do, you have to go back to open that document. We have the document here, it's open. So as you can see here, you click on the plus sign here and you see all the codes under research question 1, the plus sign here, all the codes under research question 2. So this is the codes that we're going to use to categorize. There are something that I just want to let you know. The files can be called case counts. Case count is the number of participants connected to a specific code. So you see here the 2 participants are connected to this code. And reference is also called code count. It's the number of significant information connected to a specific code. As you can see here, 2 is connected to this code, 1 is connected to that code. You can see here that 2 participants are connected to this code and then 4 are connected to this code. So normally when you are doing the categorization, you have to decide which one is the dominant code. So the dominant code is the code that have the highest number of code count and case count. So you can see that having numerous work-related tasks is considered a dominant code, right? Because we have 2 participants connected to this and also 4 significant information connected to this code. So when you are starting the categorization, you can start with the dominant code and then continue with any other code in terms of putting them into the various clusters. So now that we have our information here, you go ahead and open a Word document. So I have my Word document here and you go to layout and then you go to orientation and put in a landscape. And then you bring your first research question there because that's what we're going to do. We're going to focus on the first research question. So just to remind you that you are trying to develop themes to address the first research question. And then you create your table, insert a table, can be 4 columns or 5 columns and 2 rows. And the first one can be cluster 1, the second one cluster 2. A third, cluster 3, cluster 4. You can create more clusters depending on how the categorization goes. So you can insert and get a space here just in case you want to create more clusters, right? And then you put a cursor here and bring this one down to open the DAO here. And then what you're going to do is that you're going to start with the dominant code for the research question one. So what is the dominant code? So this is the one that I'm talking about. So what you have to do is just copy and bring that here. That will be in the first cluster. We go to the next one. You can also look for the second dominant, or you can just start at the beginning and then go down. So here we finish with this one. So you can just highlight it so that you have done this one. So being young in the profession, being young in the profession has nothing to do with having numerous work-related tasks. Whether you are young or old, you can have numerous work-related tasks. So since it doesn't have much connection with this one, we put in a second cluster and we go back again and look at the next one. You highlight this one to show that we are finished and feeling inadequate. When you are young, if you feel like you have little experience, so you feel inadequate. So I think there's a connection between being young and feeling inadequate. So you bring that one here and we go to the next one. You make sure you highlight this one because we finish. Having long hours. Having long hours may have something to do with having numerous work-related tasks, because if you have a lot of tasks to do, there's high probability for you to spend a long time, right? So you see how the pattern is. You look at the characteristics of each code. You look at the characteristics of each code and then put them in to the various clusters based on the relationship that you can establish. And you have to be very flexible here, because sometimes you may decide that, oh, I think this one doesn't really belong here. Can I put it to cluster three, right? It's all about being flexible. It's all about making sure that they have some relationship. It's all about making sure that at the end of the day, you'll be able to develop themes to address your research question. So as you're doing the categorization, this is how it's going to look like. So you see how I put everything in the various classes. So now if you finish doing this one, the next process is you look at the content here and come up with a label. This label should represent everything here, right? So having high workload represent all the code here, being new to the profession represent everything here, putting in extra effort represent everything here, having less time for family represent everything here. So you do the same thing for the cluster two, right? So the cluster one, I do the categorization, you do the categorization for cluster two, and then you label them, right, the clusters. And those labels will be themes addressing the research question that you have, right? So you have four themes here addressing the first research question and five themes addressing the second research question. When you finish, then you can send these themes back to NVivo, right? And another thing that you have to think about is that make sure that the themes that you are developing is addressing the research question. Because if it has nothing to do with the research question, then people will question the credibility of your findings, because you know you are not addressing the questions that you have, right? So now that we have the themes, you come back to NVivo. You right-click on the first research question, click on new code, and then you just copy and paste the first theme here under the first research question. And then in parentheses at the beginning, you can say theme, just to remind you that this one is not a code, but it's a theme. You check here, you can give a description, but it's not needed. You check aggregate coding from children, you click on okay. You have the team here, you do the same thing again, new code, and you bring the second one, and then you bring the team here. So next one, let me go here, you right click theme, and then you bring the next one, putting in extra effort, you check, and then you bring the next one here, right click, code, theme, and then check here and click on OK. Now that we have brought all the themes here, and the next step is to drag and drop. the codes under each of the teams. So we see here 00 is an empty container now. There's nothing inside. So you look at a table that you have and they help you to drag and drop. Being young in a profession is related to being new. So you drag and drop. Feeling inadequate is part of the being new. You drag and drop. Having numerous is also part of the second theme. The next one is having trouble carrying out duties, having trouble carrying out duties. Okay, so it's also part of the second cluster. And also less time for themselves and family, that would be part of having less time. And then here, no work family balance. Okay, so that would be also part of having less time. And then taking care of multiple patients is part of the second cluster. Unrealistic expectation is the last theme. So you're gonna do the same thing I did here. You're gonna do that the same thing here, right? So now you can see here that when you click on the plus sign, you see that the codes have been put under this research question that you have. So you see how easy it is when you export all the codes from NVivo to Excel spreadsheet and then do the analysis outside in terms of the themes and the pattern and come back to NVivo, right? So at the end of the day, this is what you're going to see. I'm going to show you the final product. As you can see here, I've created all the themes and then under each of the research questions, right? So this is how you see your quotes and the themes. All the themes are here. And then when you click on here, you can see the quote, right? So this is how the final product is going to be. If you want to export the same way, you right-click on it and go to export, and then you can export to Excel to be able to use it for you to present your findings. The next video will be visualizing your findings and also exporting the relevant output so that you'll be able to start writing or presenting your findings. I hope this one was helpful. If you have any question or a comment, put it in the comment section. I'll be happy to respond. And if you want more one-on-one consultation, contact me. My email address is info@drphilipedu.com. Thank you.